So the name of my book is Period, The Real Story of Menstruation. And I wanted to write a book about periods because I wanted to write a book that took on the stigma of menstruation. And anyone who wants like a kind of a nerdy, like wow treatment of periods, I think would enjoy the book because I really do have moments where I get into the nitty gritty and I explain, you know, super technical stuff, but in a way that shows like how wondrous and weird periods are. And and what I try to do is give it a treatment that is, I don't know, a lot more appreciative and interested than I think the stigmatized versions we've been fed in the past, which is like sort of, let's get out the bare minimum. Let's make you understand enough that you can manage your own period and Godspeed. The book is constructed in a way that kind of starts big and then kind of gets small and moves us, I hope, towards imagining a better future for menstruation science and for people who bleed. And it starts with the why of menstruation, both from a historical context and evolutionary context. Then we move to the how. That's sort of the nerdiest chapter where we get into all the little mechanisms and understand what's going on with all of that uterine architecture. Then what I consider the meat and potatoes of the book, because these are all the environmental stressors and that's mainly what I study, is we get at the energetic, the immunological, and then the psychosocial stressors that all affect periods and the menstrual cycle. And then the final chapter is this one that I had a lot of fun with, where it was my chance to look ahead and say, you know, what might the future bring us in terms of how we understand periods? You read any science fiction and fantasy book, and how many periods are you gonna learn about? There are some, there are definitely some that talk about it. But for the most part, again, the idea is that we will have solved it. And when they say solve it, they mean get rid of it. I'd like to imagine a different future for periods where we don't just get rid of it, and that's the solution, but instead we figure out how might society need to change to better accommodate them?